You could do poetry
together.
So we'll just figure something out, you know, if that happens, Michelle. But you don't know, it might work out, you know?
You just have to be flexible.
Yeah, thanks, you never Jen. Know. Hello.
Jennifer is gonna be our workout, right?
I think so. Josh this morning.
Josh is already here this morning. So
I'm setting up my phone here because poor Debbie has a notebook of passwords.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Good job, Debbie. Good job.
Life. Because I have struggles too. I have
comments ordered.
And I wish there was some way to organize. So we were trying a bunch of different passwords and can't get on at the moment.
Is this password?
Here we go. Well, we've used before, and we were doing trying with a bunch and didn't want to leave y'all hanging, right?
Okay, we have
unless you wanted to.
We'll cut back. We're gonna be.
Did you want to leave us all hanging?
No!
Of course not.
Hello. You know how you guys are.
Hi! You know our dance moves. No!
Maybe you got up on the wrong side of the bed and you just left
one
to leave us hanging.
No way. I didn't mean to leave you. Okay, so stand up with me. I want to see everyone.
Remember?
Hey, Lauren.
All right, guys, let's get started.
Okay.
Show me your best no.
No.
No. I just was curious because I know how you guys are.
Okay. All right.
No.
Hey, Siren.
You gotta show me again the best no on 3, 2, 1.
No!
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 No! No!
No!
No!
No! Getting up in cottage. Yes, we are. Love the costume. Debbie recorded it. All right, so let's just do some dance stretching because I'm kind of in the groove for that. So bring your arms out. Good, stand nice and tall, deep inhale, your feet are parallel. Good. And exhale, you're gonna shift your torso to the left. Come on back up. Inhale, really reach to the right. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, reach as far as you can. And exhale. Good. Back up. Inhale. Exhale. And inhale. And exhale. Good. One more time each side. Really reach. Come on back up. And really reach. Nice. Come on back to center. All right. And we're gonna hold here. Okay. Deep inhale. Really reach up. Right arm stacking your shoulders. Good. Nice stretching. Be cool to be dancing with the stars.
I'm not on Dance with the Stars.
That was really fun. I love Dancing with the Stars.
I hate Dancing with the Stars.
Now come on back up. Good. Reach the right arm forward. Back. Reach forward and back. Hold here for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Jordan, you're a lady, so I get it.
Hello, John.
Okay.
Down close to your knee. Really pull yourself.
Roll knees. Rotate your feet. Inhale.
4, 5, 6, 7.
No more move. I'm not here, John.
Good.
Exhale. Push back.
Tired.
Good. Bring your
Teresa.
Get those arms up, Erin.
7, 8. Inhale up. Good.
Let's.
arms out like we're dancing, Erin. We're doing dance moves.
And up. And
time for Chef Coach.
And four more.
Someone's laughing. Someone's laughing. Chef Coach is almost ready. Erin, sit up tall. I see you, Erin.
Carl just doesn't look like a coach.
Looks like a chef today.
I look like a chef.
7, 8. Come on up. 3, 2, 1. Four, five, 6, 7, 8. All right.
Go. Eight. No, I did it the right way.
Stretching out our legs. Okay, I want you to say that again. Circle back up. All right, one more time, guys. We're going to speed it up. I want you to count. Okay, count all together. We're going to reach side to side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. Forward and back. Come on down, flat back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. Hold here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nose to your knee. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Come on up. Good. Bring your chest forward. Hip crease. Come on down. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right. Come on back up. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Nice. Really, really left arm forward, right arm back. For 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nose to your knee. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Come on up, I forgot this move. I didn't. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Woo! Nice. Leg warm up. Dance leg warm up. Oh my gosh, it's so fun in here. All right, jump those feet together. And let's do, we need to warm up our arms a little bit. So let's do some circles forward with your arms. Great, straight arms. Nice. Really, really straight arms out from your shoulders and reverse. And Debbie is making, I made rice last night, extra. And my daughter ended up eating more than she was supposed to at lunch.
Yeah. Which daughter?
Rice prep. And I didn't tell her that I was taking it to Debbie's house, so she helped herself. Which is fine. Yep. What food is for, right?
Well, that's good.
Right.
Reverse. Woo! Really warming up those
arms. It's the seasoning coach.
Nice big circles. So anyways, Debbie is remaking a little bit more rice. All right, hands on the hip, or actually hands overhead, biceps by your ear. We're gonna step back, do our lunge step backs, and then forward, alternating legs. So step back, and then feet together. So everybody all together on 3, 2, 1. Step back, feet together. Great job, you guys. Step back, stay focused. Feet together. If it's too much, if it's too hard for you to focus on your legs, then you can bring your arms down. So this is more of an advanced version. Together. Watch it. Ah, sugar, na 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 na. Ah, honey, honey. Keep going.
Oh, well, we like it.
Keep going, you guys. You're doing great. A few more. Stay focused. All right, and last step back.
And bring to a boil.
Woo! Arms come down. Probably feel that. Good. Bring the arms back up. Great job, you guys. Nice participation. All right, arms down. We're going to bring our legs wide, and we're going to do some taps here. Okay, so tap, tap, sinking those nice and light all together. Three, two, one, go. Light on your feet and have fun.
Fun with I it. Always have fun.
Deep breathing. That's good. Then ignore my reminder. It's already ingrained in your head. Okay, see if you can be really light. Nice, you guys. Keep going. Feel your heart rate coming up. Keep going. Erin, I need you to count down from 10. 9.
Oh,
8. Come on, Erin. 7. 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo! Stop. Nice. Deep inhale. Oh, lengthen your spine. And exhale. All right. Great. And now we're going to do our skaters for about 30 seconds. Ice skaters. Kind of fun. Good dance. All right.
It's great. It's not just fun. It's great.
Be as simple as you can in 3, 2, 1. Yeah. Arms out. Oh, you guys, you're doing great. I'm trusting that you're doing this.
Still kick Saran.
You guys are doing great. Keep it up. You guys are looking like speed skaters.
Woo! Get those arms moving. Nice. And we're counting down from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! The arms up, nice job. Exhale, arms come down. Beautiful. All right, we're gonna do our cross with high. So I had to catch my breath. Arms out to the side. Good, really like straight off from your shoulders, and you're gonna bring that knee as high as you can and tap it with the opposite hand, okay? All together in 3, 2, 1. Exhale, knees come up. Nice. You can find to yourself. Not just slap. A lot of oxygen. Nice. Have you guys here some? Feed it up. Awesome. And coming down from 10, 9, 8, 7.
Come on, 6, Michelle, keep it up. Keep it 5, up. Get those knees up.
4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo. Oh, great job. And exhale. Arms down. You guys are doing really good. Okay, so now we're gonna stand. We're standing up nice and tall. And this with bands before. But the goal here is we're going to just bring our right leg out the side, abductor stretch. So out and together. So you want to flex the foot. The goal here is to stand strong in mountain pose and not be doing this with your torso, okay? That would be using like momentum and gravity to your advantage, but it's really a so you want to stay really tall and strong in your left leg, right? And then just bring that right leg out and then together. So we're gonna do 12 of these. Everyone reach out as high as you can without compromising your upper body and then legs together. Good. Out and together. And if you don't do something, that's okay. That's more important than doing this. Out and together.
Now, I think I'm late on this one.
Together, you may have done an extra one.
Like that
garlic. If we have six more. Five. And four. And three. And two. And one. Woo! Awesome. So you probably feel your legs a bit of a burn. And that's normal. So, standing on your right leg, like strong in mountain pose, hands on your same thing with your left leg. So, you're just flexing your foot, bringing it straight as far as you can, left, together.
Which foot?
12. So, I'm mirroring you. So, you want to do the other leg.
Gotcha.
Yeah. So, but I'm mirroring you, so I told you to do your left leg. So that's one. Bring it as far as you can. Two. Three. Like I said, you guys have done this with bands, but it's challenging enough to not do it with bands.
Four.
Eight more.
Oh,
all of it. Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Six. Whoops. Five more. And four. And three. And two. And one. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Oh, feel the burn. Yes, that is a burn. So
totally.
When I use the bands, it's actually I tend to lean. So if you really engage your core and tighten, stay strong here, you won't use other muscles to overcompensate. Okay, so standing nice and tall here, we're going standing on that right leg, lift your left leg up, good, and straighten it, flex it away from you, without leaning back. So watch right here from the side. You're just pushing that foot away and standing up nice and tall, not this. Okay, so it's bringing the leg up as far as you can and then bringing it down. Actually, instead of bending the knee, we're just gonna stand on, and I'm showing you the side view. So bring the leg straight up as high as you can without moving your upper body, lowering it forward and lowering it. Good. Lift and lower. Nice. Lift, squeeze and lower.
Here's
Penelope. Nice. Lower. Try to go for three more. And if you're really motivated, you could do even a couple more after that. Last one here, or do a couple more if you're inspired. Woo! And shake it out. Great job, you guys. So that is a bit of a challenge if you're not over getting by doing it like this. Okay, so I'm gonna go to the other leg. So instead of bending the knee at first, just straighten that. Flex the toes so you're curling up towards your face. And here we go, stand nice and tall. You're gonna lift up as high as you can and now bring the leg down. lift up. And if you need to hold on to something, maybe just use your finger, like barely, barely touch for that extra support.
And lower. So it sits.
Exhale. Lower. Exhale. Lower. Three more. Or you could do five more. One. Last one. Nice. Woo, shake it out. Good job, you guys. Up a little bit for you. Okay. So we're going to do our stationary airplane. I almost forgot what it was. So your feet are about hip width apart. Make sure that you're not cramped or anything. All right. And bend your, sink your hips back and then reach your arms forward. Sink your hips back a little bit more. So like somebody's pulling your hips back and somebody's pulling your arms forward. Ah! Ah, that's a great ride. And now open up your arms. I love it because we can just sit here, right? You're flying your arms back and draw your shoulder blades together down the back. Lift up your head. Nice, sink your hips a little lower, you guys. Like go to the edge. Nice deep breaths. We're gonna stay here for 10, 9, 8. Keep breathing. Okay. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Press into your heels. Inhale, come on up. Oh, nice job. And exhale, arms come down. Woo. It's amazing, even when you're not moving your body, how much heat is flowing still. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing. This time we're going to, I'm going to have you guys, when you're in airplane pose, is lift your heels at the end for that little bit more of a challenge, okay? So here we go, really sink your hips, go way back as you bend your knees. Reach your arms forward and imagine that like Debbie is pulling you with her arms and I'm pulling you back by your hips and
Debbie's not even here.
She's in the
kitchen.
Yeah, she is. She's in the kitchen.
Okay, that's kind of funny.
Okay.
Now,
face around.
Okay, there we go. Draw your shoulder blades together down your back. Sink your hips low and back with your arms. Okay, good. Lift your chest a little bit. Sink the hips a little low. 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stay here, stay here. Heels. Lift your heels. Balance your chest a little bit more. Heels are high. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ah. Straighten the legs. Nice job, you guys. Woo. Awesome job. Hands come down. So impressed. Okay.
Can you cook it?
Still moving on.
Can I what?
And we're in the kitchen, so we're doing more lay stuff here.
Yeah, careful. You don't want to break stuff in there.
Yeah, I don't love doing floor work without a mat. I'm kind of snobby about that. I don't think I would have done good in India on the dirt.
Do it in India. That's the next thing that you need to do.
Lunge. Left leg forward. Right leg is back. You're in a high lunge. And we have to do our mantra because it's so fun. Right?
Is it Adam's thing?
So really reach up. Yeah, biceps by your ears. Nice. And all together on 3, 2. One, we are strong. We are warriors. Hands down. Switch legs. Do it. Hands. Come up into your high lunge. Lunge. Yep. In this pose, right? So get in your position. We're gonna do our chant. Two, one.
We are strong.
We
are people.
We
are
loved.
We are warriors.
Woo! I was jealous. There is a song, I have written a song about her. She's not gonna like it. Trust me, she won't.
How's it going, Lauren?
Out of the way. They can't stay home.
We're almost done with the workout, guys. 5 more minutes, okay?
Woo-hoo. Now bend. So you guys know you're in a lunge, your hands are down, and now straighten. And bend.
Look at this costume.
Nice. Straighten.
So bright.
And bend. Keep your right arm under your right shoulder. Reach your left arm forward. Good. Like, imagine that, you know, Debbie's pulling your hand. And now let go, and you're reaching up with that left arm and doing a big circle around, down and back, and 2 more times. So really open up, big circle. Notice where you might get a little bit stuck, and you can stay there, work through it.
Oh my goodness, look at that.
You can always take a couple deep breaths, and where you stick, that's where it's kind of hard to complete the circle. Nice. Bring the hand down. Straighten the leg again the best you can. And see if you can, get the leg straight, then you're going to curl your toes up towards the ceiling. You guys can't see that, but your toes will be lifted and you just be pressing your heel on the ground. Meanwhile, Debbie is dancing with stars in the background and cooking.
Lucky. Okay. I'll watch it.
Next legs. So
you're in a watch it, Debbie.
Now straighten your front leg.
Isn't that fun up there?
So you have your left leg forward, you're just straightening it. And you're trying the back heel down. Whatever heel's in the back. Good. Now bend that front leg. Good. Reach your right arm forward. Good. Circle around. So really reach forward and then circle and open up. Good. And do it 2 more times. Big circle around and back. Is everything okay?
Yeah.
Debbie's good at multitasking.
I know she is. This is Debbie.
Yeah. Kind of have like this pinch. Circle around. Okay. And now straighten the front leg the best you can. Walk your
the way God made her.
Shoulders. And maybe press into your front heel and curl your toes up.
Oh, you
want to
press
maybe.
I'll give you a piece of paper. And then they teach you how to draw.
Good. Bend that front leg. Step your back leg forward. Good. Inhale. Come on up. And exhale. Arms come down. Okay.
Oh. So first you start with a circle.
I don't know why, but I'm a little warm. Okay. So feet are together. Left leg. Listen to my word. And cross it over your right. I like this twist. Want you guys to see. See? Right? Then you're going to bring your hands down. So your front knee is bent, the back leg is. Okay, if you need to hold on to a block here, that's. Walk your hands to the left. And now walk them back to center. And walk them to the right.
Here, you want some more spinach?
So this is. Great for your IT band. In the back leg, the front knee has a bit of a bend. Come back to center. Uncross your legs. Good. And now swing your left leg behind your right. Okay, so it's just the opposite, and I'm mirroring you, what you just did. So the back leg is straight. Front knee has a little bit of a bend. Walk your hands to one side. The more you keep the back leg straight, the more you'll feel it in your IT band. Come back to center and then walk it the other way. The other side. You should feel, I hope everybody feels it. And you can use a block.
You know I feel it.
Back of my knee.
My arms could break off.
Your arms?
That's really how much I'm feeling it.
The back leg. Okay, uncross the back leg, bring the feet together. Inhale, come halfway up. Exhale, bow, let the head go. Through down, inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, arms come down. All right, so our after flag salute in honor of Mr. Adam Billington. All together in three, two, one.
Hey, what a day.
Woo!
Nice.
That's, ooh, there's coach. Woo. Ooh.
What's up, guys?
Okay, well, thank you all for the workout. We'll come back to that.
Coach! Ooh, it's Chef Coach today.
Right? Chef Coach! Look at that! Oh my gosh, it's just like Food Network here.
Oh, totally.
It is.
I got my little bowl of ingredients, my garlic.
And I...
Oh, look at this.
And my shallots.
Oh, man. Oh, he does not. Look at his coach. Look at his
or chef. Today we're calling you chef.
Look at his beard.
Chef King.
Look at his mustache. He does not look like a coach.
Chef James. Is that Chef P?
Right, Chef P.
Very good. Woohoo! Chef P's in the house. Chef P.
Woo!
All right.
Exactly.
Yeah. Rock and roll.
So, Coach, do you want us to play a country song, or do you want us to get started?
You can play a song. That's totally cool.
I'm spotlighting you.
Everyone, I need help. What's the number one country song right now? Tina?
Yeah, Tina. What's the number one country song?
What is it, Tina?
It's Country Day.
This is
International Country Music Day.
Karen, come on.
Ladies, you get a second.
Oh, Lady A is a country.
International Country Music
Lady A
Day.
Is a country music, I think.
Something by Jason Aldean.
Oh, not Taylor Swift?
Sugarland.
Oh, there we go. Yeah.
Sugarland.
Okay.
That's a good
Sugarland
one.
Sugarland is perfect.
I'll what? Find something.
What?
Does it say stuck on you?
From who?
No, sorry, it's stuck like glue. That's what it
stuck
is.
Like stuck glue. Like glue. Oh, I know that song.
Let's do that one.
That's a good one.
Oh, yeah,
and I'm just going to play it.
Okay.
I can cue it. I can cue it right now. I just have to skip
home
the
Sweet Alabama. Oh. That was a good Home Sweet
Alabama. Oh, that is a really
home
good
Alabama.
Country song.
That was a better one.
Yeah, Luigi's right. Luigi is right.
Sweet Home Alabama.
Okay, so, right.
All right, Jennifer.
That's okay.
Sweet Home Alabama,
I would say fits.
What Luigi says.
Who's it by? Leonard Skinner. Okay, there we go.
Oh,
how did I not know
so
that?
Cute. Oh, you have a silk chef.
Oh, my
that goes in there.
Oh my gosh! He's your sous chef.
He is. Oh, it is. It's really hot. You can say hi, Jude.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm so
yeah, you see yourself?
Cute.
What's
your name?
I'm sorry.
Hey, okay, guys. Nice I got the song.
Is it cute? Little baby.
Go ahead and get started.
All right, guys. Hello. So the most important thing when you cook risotto, guys, is you want to you really want to saute the garlic and the onions. But I actually got shallot because I like that kind of subtle flavor. Here are what a garlic and a shallot look like.
Oh wow! Oh
here's
yeah.
garlic, and here's a shallot. Shallots are kind of like a mix between an onion and a garlic. They're kind of cool tasting.
Yeah.
So what I do usually when I cook is I try to kind of get everything all ready to go, all organized. So mm-hmm. I have my garlic here. It's about 6 cloves. And I did 1 large shallot. And the most important thing was when you start off cooking, guys, you want your oil extremely hot. Here mm-hmm. I put some olive oil in this pan. So you want this... You want the oil screaming hot, guys, because you want all that flavor to be absorbed right into the olive oil. So if you hear it sizzling, that's a good thing. So the most important thing is to keep stirring when you're first cooking the garlic and the shallots in there. You really want to stir everything around. Jude, do you want to help me put the last little bit of garlic in there? Want to help me scoop?
You have a fork inside. Oh, you want a spoon? I think this rice might be better than that.
Good job.
You're a good helper. Not yet. That goes in a little bit.
That's weird.
So yeah, you just stir around the garlic and onion and shallot. Takes a little bit.
I have to sit down.
But it's really important to keep stirring it around because you don't want any of that to burn, any of that stuff to kind of char. But you want it to, it doesn't matter if it sticks to the bottom because we're going to deglaze it with a little bit of white wine later. So all that stuff on the bottom of the pan, that'll all come up and be good flavor.
Yeah.
Good job, bud.
Yep, not yet though. Almost.
Okay, maybe it just doesn't look very good to me for some reason.
Are you okay, Jennifer?
Sorry, guys. I didn't realize we weren't muted.
How is your rice, Jennifer?
Oh, okay. So I didn't realize Debbie had started making this rice.
Let me spotlight you.
I'm going to show you guys how to make the simple risotto.
I have to tell you,
I don't think it looks good. I'm gonna be honest with you.
Good job being honest, Jen. Good job being honest.
Yeah. It looks like mush.
It looks a little clump. Like, remember the video, you guys, when they showed us the clumps?
Yeah.
So we'll have to compare. It's really hard to do.
That's the boxed risotto. They did it fast. Our workout, voila.
There you go. Get your carbs, guys.
Yummy, yummy. I run any like it. Cottage kitchen perfected. We can go back to Coach. I didn't realize that I was, we were not muted. So
sorry about that.
Didn't mean to interfere.
No problem.
So the garlic and onion, the garlic and shallots, guys, are almost done. You want them to look kind of like this yellowish kind of color. That way they're nice and caramelized. So they're almost done. I'm about to add the rice here in a few minutes. And then we can get started on the rest of the risotto. Then comes the fun part. You just have to keep stirring. That's heavy, Jude. And oh my goodness, guys, I wish you could smell the smell that's going on in here.
Oh man.
With garlic and shallot sauteing. Holy moly. Hey Jude, we need the rice. Can you hand me the rice? Can you hand that to me? Then guys, you want to pour your rice in?
That's okay.
It's all right. We just lost a little bit.
Good job, buddy.
Good job.
We have a little less risotto.
Good job.
All right. So once this is in, guys, you really want to stir around the rice to get it all nice and coated in the olive oil. And then we're gonna grab that in a second. Jude, you want to put that in now?
Yep.
All right, put it in.
Yep. Good job.
And then now what we're going to do, guys, is we're going to deglaze it with a little bit of white wine. And you want to cook out all the alcohol in the wine. So when you're stirring, you really want to stir it. And you want all that liquid to be absorbed. So all that's left in there is just flavor, guys.
Oh, I wish Izzy was on because I gave her this apron. Do you remember it, Debbie?
No, that's cool, isn't it?
Okay. And it's this really cool maroon apron. I don't know if it's still at Hidden Wings. And I believe it says, I cook with wine and then sometimes I add it to my food. I think that's the same.
Is that hers? Did you return it?
So guys, when it's all stirred in, it should look about this color, a little bit toasty looking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then we heat up our stock. And all I did was just use normal chicken broth that you buy from the store. And then I added a little bit of my own seasoning, some Suji Q's. This is my favorite seasoning in the world. I put it on everything.
And then I cut it with a little bit of water, so that way the chicken stock, when you stir it into the risotto, isn't right. as strong. Because you're going to get all this concentrated flavor of this chicken broth at, into the rice. So you scoop a little bit in. This one's a little warm. Need to go up just a little bit more. Stir this guy in. A couple scoops at a time.
Yum.
And then this is the really most important part, guys. You really just want to stir it. You just want to give it some love. You don't want to be beating it. You don't want to be being mean. You just want to stir it. You want all that water to be absorbed, all that starch to come out. And then once all the water is absorbed, you just keep repeating the process, guys. So you don't want to stir it too much, because what ends up happening is you'll get clumpy risotto.
Sure.
You just want to stir it just enough
it's gonna
to get all
mush.
That water moved around. All that stock, all that nice good flavor, just stir it around all throughout that risotto, all throughout the rice.
So there is a difference between stock and broth. Does anybody know the difference between like chicken stock and chicken broth? Mm-hmm.
No.
No? Okay,
no.
Thanks for your honesty. Does anybody know the difference?
No.
No.
No. So stock is more concentrated. It's
okay.
It's
not as filtered.
Right. So you can think of broth is kind of like a watered down stock. So the stock is going to be a lot more flavorful and definitely better than water. So
if you
were using this recipe, you could enhance it by adding the water is adding using stock.
But I use broth. I use broth in yours.
Oh, Debbie used broth. So see, Debbie was already.
You can use a vegetable, or you can use chicken, and I used chicken just because that's what I had.
Okay.
So that's just an idea. If you do have something like this at home, the easier version.
So guys, this is what it looks like. The process looks like so far. See how the rice is kind of fluffing up and all that sauce is kind of going all over the place. And
oh, it looks good, Coach.
Oh, yeah.
The key to this, guys, is adding just a little bit of stock at a time. See how it's kind of getting creamier and creamier?
Uh-huh. But you
just
can't
have to
go
keep
and
stirring.
Do anything.
You have to stay right there and stir it. You can't leave, right?
Nope. You cannot leave for a minute because you constantly have to stir.
And your heat is medium low?
My heat is actually medium, and then the stock is on medium high. Because what you're actually doing is boiling, you're actually cooking the rice with the heat from the stock as well. So just continue the process.
We want dinner.
Oh, Teresa, you're funny.
That's good.
I'm coming over with my bowl and my mask and my gloves and you know what?
No kidding.
Social distance.
I'll leave a bowl by the front door.
Now push it out with a broom. That's like 6 feet, right?
Right, exactly.
Push.
Are you just joking, Teresa?
I'm thinking about it.
I know you are.
And so is guys, it's just all about stirring, all about continuing to just keep.
Thanks. Keep, you know we love coach.
Oh, man, you just have to stir. A lot of people think this is really difficult, but what it really is just time consuming and just a little bit labor intensive, you know?
Yeah, that's a lot of stirring.
Mm-hmm. You know, my mom showed me this television show, Hell's Kitchen, and mm-hmm. it had a
the same character that was always so angry. And because this angry chef only wanted perfection, he only wants food to be perfect.
Oh, yeah. Gordon Ramsay is very intense.
You better not come to my kitchen.
You better not come in my kitchen either.
Aisle of my kitchen.
I'm nothing in my kitchen is perfect. You know why? Because I'm not perfect. There's nothing
exactly
in
the world that's
perfect. Mm-hmm. I guess what Gordon Ramsay needs to realize that not everything's perfect.
That's right. I agree.
Mm-hmm. Wish he did though.
I know. So
Bing Jim.
So guys, just keep stirring it, keep stirring it. It's almost about ready.
Isn't that delicious?
It's looking more and more creamy, guys. I'm going to show you right now. See how much more creamy it's looking?
Yeah. Oh, good job.
Oh, yeah.
That looks so good.
Yeah, we dinner tonight.
Oh, yep. Remember.
And then after we get done with this, we're going to add a little bit of, we're going to saute some mushrooms here in a pan, and we're going to add some Parmesan cheese and send it over the top.
Wow.
What kind of mushrooms do you use, Coach?
I actually use kermini mushrooms.
Mmm.
And guys, do you know what kind of mushrooms kerminis are?
No.
They're little portobello mushrooms.
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. Because cool. I'm using these. I didn't realize. Oops. They're baby Bella mushrooms.
Mmm.
So the cremini must be smaller than...
Yeah, the cremini is a little bit smaller than the baby Bella one.
You can say hi to her, Michelle.
Oh, it's yeah.
Just walk by.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Coach.
What's up?
Michelle wants to say hi to her sister. Remember, they know each other.
Yeah, now I remember
your
sister.
Want to say hi, Christina? Hi, it's Michelle.
Hi, Christina.
Hi.
I remember you
hey,
now.
Hey, Christina.
Hi, Christina.
Lauren, nice to meet you.
Yeah. It's Michelle's, and they'll see each other.
Yep.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That just shows you that time goes by
it's
fast.
It's a small world.
It's a really small world.
She is, you know, that's insane.
And Coach is still stirring.
Yep, still stirring.
So you really can't leave, and you have to keep stirring. You can't just...
You can't take care of Serenity.
You
can't. Definitely not. But look at how good it's looking, guys. It's already looking nice and creamy.
Oh, mm-hmm. Nice.
Wow.
Nice and smooth, you know. You want it to look smooth. You don't want to have any chunks.
Right. That is correct.
Good job.
So nice, dude.
That's so cute.
You're such a good helper.
Are you a helper?
Are you helping, Jude? Oh, you got a Cheerio?
Oh, yeah.
Sweet.
Nice.
Nice, man.
Oh,
I love you.
Nummy, nummy.
Yum, 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 yum.
Does he like this food, too? Does he like this food?
What'd you say, Jordan?
Does he like this food?
He
likes cheese.
He likes cheese, so we might be able to get him to eat a little bit of it.
Yeah.
I like cheese, too.
Serenity tried what we made, and she really liked it.
Yeah, she actually ate the bowl of it. So,
oh, nice.
You know, don't judge a book by its cover, right?
Well, that's how it is. You can't judge a book by its cover.
Come over, you have to have one no thank you bite. That means that
that's
at least
right.
You tried it.
That's right. That's a great way.
Exactly.
One bite.
Yeah, that's right.
Because you'll never know if you like it or not.
Yeah.
Exactly. It's always good to try things, guys, you know?
I like to try. Come on, Teresa. Come on, drive.
I know. I got to get some of that.
I droid on top.
What on top?
Fly droid. Those flying airplane things.
Oh, a drone?
A drone?
Oh, a drone.
A
drone.
Oh, a drone, yeah. Delivered
by
drone.
Yeah, that would be cool. Hey, that's a thing in some cities. I just think I'm a little far for that. But it's a dream. I can have. Maybe I invest in a drone. This could be
the rest of your orange ones. Well, not a true candy.
Looking good, but I think. So guys, you just have to keep stirring. You can't really go away from it. And this is how much it fluffs up to, guys. This is what it kind of looks like once you get towards the end of the process, but not 100% towards the end. See how it... Sorry, that was my dog. She wants some of Jude's cheese.
What's his name?
Her name is Miko. She's a little Morkie. A little Morkie, Maltese Yorkie mix.
I think they like cheese.
Right on. Love cheese. It doesn't.
So now what other ingredients do you have to put in there, Coach?
All I have to do now is just, I'm going to saute the mushrooms here in a little bit, and all I'm going to add is just some really good Parmesan cheese.
Okay.
And it's that simple. Because really what you're doing is tasting the stock and the, you're tasting the stock, the rice, and the cheese, and the mushrooms combined. Kind of okay. Everything together.
So it's turning out the way you hoped it would.
Exactly.
Awesome. Oh, and okay, here comes another ladle of broth.
Yep.
Too
late. You always want to keep it at least a little bit liquidy so that way you have it be able to stir. Because okay. You don't want the stuff to stick to the bottom, guys. That'd be the worst.
Oh, okay. I might have that happen.
So you just want to stir, keep stirring. See how creamy it's starting to look, guys?
Yeah.
It looks like oatmeal, but it's not.
It does look like oatmeal, Jacob, but it's not.
It does, kind of. That's the kind of consistency you really want. You really want it to kind of be almost like a creamy pasta, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's getting all that starch. The starch is coming out.
Yep, all that starch is coming out of the rice and into the stock, and it's making its own sauce.
That's right.
True.
It's a delicious flavor. And then when he sautés those wonderful mushrooms, you know, when I was younger, my mother never cooked with mushrooms.
Really?
Oh, there they are. Oh, yes, I grew up in a different type of, she was a very picky eater, so I didn't get to try things.
Oh, kind of like me in a way.
Until I met my husband and my world came alive. And I ate broccoli for the first time. I'm all, whoa, this is pretty good. And then I started trying different things that his mother would cook, my mother-in-law. So luckily I had a wonderful mother-in-law that cooked and I learned a lot of things.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't know germ foul. Yeah, they're germ foul.
I guess all in one.
Guys, I wish you can taste this.
Oh.
Holy moly.
Wow. Oh, God.
Maybe like two or three more ladles full, and then we're going to add the cheese.
Okay. What are you going to serve that with tonight for your dinner? Are you going to serve it with pork chops, with chicken? What are you going to serve it with?
I think I'm going to serve it with some turkey burger.
Oh, that sounds really good.
Add some Parmesan cheese to those, too.
Oh,
so
nice.
So everything ties together.
Yes. You know what? I don't think there's a day that goes by that I don't have cheese.
Me neither.
Oh, everybody loves cheese. Everybody loves cheese.
Well, I don't know about everybody. But
everybody.
I think my mother doesn't.
With the exception of your mother, everybody else.
There you go.
It's okay though.
My mother just doesn't know what she doesn't know what she's in for.
Just more cheese for me. So
the mushrooms just went in, guys. I'm sauteing them around in a little bit of olive oil and Susie Q's.
Do you put in fresh garlic too, or do you just use the garlic from the Susie Q?
What?
Do you use fresh garlic too, or do you just use the garlic that's in the Susie Q?
Oh, I use crushed garlic. I used chopped up garlic as well.
Okay.
Cool. I used a little bit left over of what was in my bowl for the risotto.
The package.
So another trick that I was going to do and show you guys.
And this is the FedEx mostly comes.
If you have a box like this,
You can double check it.
This is wannabe risotto.
Yeah.
This is out of the box risotto, but
they come like layered.
Authentic, yes. real risotto. So what she's going to do, though, is you take a box, and now she's going to add to it to make it more more enhanced.
I'm going to saute some onions that I've already chopped up, and then I'm going to do that right now. So you can always do this, and then I'm going to add my little tiny baby mushrooms that I actually need to cut up. And I have a question. No. I have a question for Coach. Do you wash your mushrooms?
I do, yes.
Okay. I do too. Some people say don't wash your mushrooms and you're just supposed to like brush them off.
Sometimes
or with a towel,
I do, sometimes
but
I don't.
Yeah, I wash them because sometimes they have some funky stuff on the outside, you know?
Yeah.
So
I don't want
mushrooms. Mushrooms should be washed because sometimes they're grown in, yes, yeah.
Yeah.
Some growers, they're grown in, yeah, heavy, heavy fertilizer, like cow fertilizer.
Yeah.
So, exactly.
Yeah. So I, for one, wash my mushrooms.
Yeah,
you don't want it to smell like cow pies or cow manure.
No,
exactly.
You never know.
I want mushrooms to be funky, but not that funky.
That's right.
That's right.
Okay, I was just
that's great.
Having a mushroom debate: whether you wash them or you don't wash them. Mine are organic, and I still wash them. So, meanwhile, I mean, Coach can still keep demonstrating, but I just want to let you know that I'm kind of doing this in the background. I have a little bit of olive oil, and I'm going to be sauteing my onions and garlic to add to my little bit of risotto that I have going on. And Debbie has another little masterpiece going on, of course.
A masterpiece?
This is butter! You always cook with butter. No, everything.
See how it's kind of, guys, see how it's kind of sticking together and weaving back?
Oh.
See how it's kind of just slowly kind of going back in?
Look at how nice and thick, you guys.
That means it's almost done.
Wow.
How's
your cooking, Debbie?
Done like the,
I'm going to saute my onion in my butter, yeah. But let's see what Coach is going to do.
Well, you're also part of the cooking.
Jordan, if you want to see them, hit gallery view.
Oh,
what?
And I learned how to do the chef split by a whole bunch of practice, guys. So don't try to do it unless you're good at it. Because I don't know how many things I've dropped learning how to do this process.
Okay, and so he's already sautéed his mushrooms. Good, good, good.
Mm-hmm.
That is excellent.
How long did you saute the mushrooms for?
It's until they kind of look a little bit wilted.
A little smaller. Kind of like they look a little smaller.
Yeah, they kind of shrink up a little bit and absorb.
Yeah.
Okay. I always like to learn new tricks.
Yes. Wyatt, do you like mushrooms? Or no? I mean, some people don't like mushrooms.
I don't like mushrooms.
I love mushrooms.
Mm.
Or some people like Sarah.
Would you like a taste test? Someone?
Sarah can.
Michelle, do you
I'm
like
I'm allergic
mushrooms?
To mushrooms.
Oh,
gee, that's not good.
I have another
Who said
friend,
that?
Amy, that's
Who
allergic
is allergic to mushrooms?
Adam said that.
I thought it was Wyatt.
No, it was Adam.
No, I think it was Adam.
Oh.
Really?
Oh, look at, Coach, I've never been able to do that.
Me either.
I dropped a lot of logic.
I can't do
it.
That. I cannot do
we
that.
Come next week.
Yeah, I just can't imagine Debbie doing something like that.
I try.
Sometimes.
You know what? He doesn't have to wear a mask because he's already covered his mouth. Hey, Coach, you're already covering your mouth and you don't need to wear a mask. Yeah, because he has fur.
Is it because he has the beard?
No. Oh, yeah, I need to get hair net from the mouth.
Because he's got the beard.
Almost done, guys. It's just needs a little bit crunchy, so that's okay. All you have to do is just keep stirring, just keep giving it love, don't whack the heck out of it, just stir it really softly. You just really want to stir everything around, guys. Mushrooms are almost done.
Mm-hmm.
Good. They look really good, oh, guys.
Wow.
So he's almost done with his risotto. And then Amy, I was with her today. Jennifer is sauteing her onions and she's going to put some garlic in. She's going to add it to the box of risotto. That's what you can do with boxes if you don't want to start from scratch. Then you can add things to it and enhance it, make it better, make a whole meal out of it. And what I have started, it's called spinach rice pilaf. And it's very similar to risotto, but easier.
Yucky sauce in there.
And it's got spinach in it.
Yeah, can you drain the mushrooms real quick? So guys, what we're doing right now is the mushrooms are done, so we're going to drain them so that way the olive oil and stuff don't go into this nice creamy risotto. You don't want to really mess up, you don't want to mess up this beautiful creation right here. Let's look at this thing.
So cute.
Look at the smoothness, guys. No clumps whatsoever. See how smooth it is?
Oh
wow.
Yeah.
Like snow.
Like snow! Now you're talking.
One more stir of stock, and then we're good to go. I'll add the mushrooms. I'll add the Parmesan, guys, and I'll show you the finished product. How's that sound?
Yeah.
Excellent.
I'm excited, guys. This is looking so good. My sister taste tested it, and she said it's great.
Awesome.
Good job, sis.
Easy. Yeah. You're just so, you know, it's very hot. You gotta be really calm and mellow and stirring.
And cooking is very relaxing if you get the right stuff and you understand how to do it. It can be very meditative, guys.
Really?
Yeah. Because I'm not good at any other art, but man, oh man, am I a cooking machine.
Cooking
is, it's called one of the active meditations, so that's it's a thing.
Really?
It's a real thing. Yep.
Well
I
believe,
you know,
it
about meditating, Amy. You're
that's
the only
what
one.
I do is I'm in the kitchen and then I can make everything go away.
Yeah,
in the kitchen. And so this is garlic. I'm mincing the garlic. So I'm putting the garlic clove in, and then I'm pressing on my, and then I'm making it mince instead of chopping it.
Oh, yeah.
Serenity's a good helper. She's being a very good helper.
She's stirring onion. So saute
onion. Nice.
But it smells really good.
That is some awesome risotto, guys.
Oh my.
So now what we're going to do, guys, is we're going to add the Parmesan cheese. So you want to add it a little bit at a time. So this is a finished product, guys. Looks nice and creamy.
Wow.
So now we're just going to add a ton of Parmesan cheese a little bit at a time. Oh. Stir that bad boy in.
Oh,
stir
the butter. Here comes.
Oh, yeah. Look at it.
Cheese.
Oh, let it snow, let it snow.
Oh my god. Wow. So happy.
Wow.
Oh, Coach. Would you say that's a cut of Parmesan cheese?
What?
Would you say that's about a cup of Parmesan cheese?
Yeah, about a half a cup. I'm gonna add about a cup total.
Okay.
That looks really good.
You see the cheese starting to ooze out.
Oh yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Starting to melt. What would it do without a hit?
And if I would recommend getting a more expensive Parmesan cheese, guys, because it does make a difference in the melt quality.
Really?
Yeah. Because a lot of the times, especially if you get Kraft, they actually have a thing where they can add wood to it. How crazy is that?
Yeah, they do. They add tiny grains of sawdust.
Oh my god, that's horrible.
And it keeps it from kind of coagulating. It keeps it all separate.
Oh my god.
So it doesn't fall up in the can.
Wow.
And then the mushrooms, guys.
Oh, here comes the mushrooms. There he goes. You must have a large frying pan there.
I do. It's pretty big. It's about a 12-inch, 14-inch skillet. And then this one is about a 14-inch skillet as well.
Oh, wow. There's a lot in there.
Now it's just stirring everything together, guys. Getting everything so that way everyone gets a bite of mushroom. Everyone gets a bite of cheese.
Mikey.
And then we'll be good to go.
That looks pretty good.
I'm going to look up that whole
yummy
Parmesan cheese and sawdust. That does not sound good at all.
Yeah, it's actually an FDA requirement. I looked that up and I was like, oh my gosh, that's crazy.
That is crazy.
What's crazy?
I don't know. How would that be good for our insides?
I know, right?
You want to see the finished product, Jude?
A lot of roughage, I guess.
Yeah, roughage is right.
Does it look good?
Lordy.
You can eat it. Hope you try it. Let him. I want to see.
Well, guys, this is the finished product.
Wow!
You should try it,
nice
buddy.
And, nice and cheesy. Really hot.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Oh, wow.
You should try it, buddy. Yeah, you should.
Okay.
You want to buy? Oh my god, I'm so jealous.
Dude.
Why you laugh?
That was good, guys. I'm so bummed you guys can't try it.
No, I looked for clues.
Yeah.
I mean, is he going to eat the whole thing? Hey.
So it's that simple, guys. It's not too difficult, right?
You're right.
It look really simple. Oh my gosh. Very meditative.
Yeah, it's hot dogs, everyone.
Yeah.
Relax. Hot dogs next
look,
week.
He's stirring
hot dogs next week.
He was stirring for 30 minutes.
Yeah, so all it is, guys, is just stirring. But you can, really? Like I said, meditative,
just
you know?
Just stirring. What?
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
So is that something you guys think you might be able to do?
I think so. Family? I would love to try it. When we get together and Hidden Wings.
Yeah, I want to try
that one. We can take turns stirring.
Go to the kitchen at the church.
That's right. That was great, Coach. Oh my gosh.
Coach, thank you.
Of course.
It's all fine. It's because
that was perfect. Mm-hmm. So Jennifer, onions are already sauteed, and I was just shaving the rest of my Parmesan. And, when you have a wedge of Parmesan, there's about a half an inch that you don't want to break, kind of the waxy seal. So it's not going to taste good, so you want to throw that out.
Yeah.
That's if you're grating it fresh. It is...
Here to buy
already grated, So I just got my mushrooms in here, and I just think that this is a great way to, you know, simplify. Then you add it to your box mix, and it's so much better.
Yeah, it is a lot better.
Okay, so now my onions are ready, and I'm going to add my garlic. And my onions were only in there for 3 minutes, probably longer. And then now my garlic goes in, not for very long. And it's 3 cloves of garlic. How many people like spinach?
I do.
I do.
No, thank you.
Guess what? You have to cook with spinach and put it in. So the recipe says that after I cook my onions for 3 minutes, I put my garlic and my salt, and I stir until fragrant. Well, it's fragrant. I really love it.
It is fragrant in here.
Now it tells me to put my spinach in. Oh, it's okay. It's on tape. We do it. Does this look like a lot of spinach?
Yum, 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 yum.
Yummy, 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 yummy.
It does, but it...
I'm good.
Cooks down. So now I'm going to put good. All the spinach, which is cleaned, and I'm going to put it in my pan.
Mm-hmm.
Spinach is a great thing to add to recipes. Yeah, you can add it to eggs. You can add it, like, I'm going to put rice in this, you guys, actually.
Yummy.
Yeah.
Sounds delicious.
Doesn't it though? It's hot. Put it under
the water.
Uh-oh.
I think she got a little scared. It must have touched the pan. Yeah. I think she got a little scared. It is scary with hot pans.
Is she all
Did
right?
Did she touch it?
Yeah, she's okay.
It has to be a two.
It does happen.
You okay, Saran?
So what I've done was I stuck her hand in a bowl of cold water.
Yeah, it happened to
Oh,
me.
Good.
That's good.
When I was a little, like her age.
Yes, thank you, Debbie. It's a little scary.
You okay, Saran? You okay?
Yeah.
And I'm a brave girl.
Aww.
You just scared
her. What a sweetheart. What a brave girl. What a brave girl you are.
Okay. And I'm stirring the cake.
Thank you, Mom.
It's wilting down. So these pans are really hot. You cannot touch the pans. This is very hot. The only thing you can touch is the bowl. And then it says stir in the spinach and cook and stirring occasionally until the leaves are wilted and that there's no more liquid in there. Well, I don't have very much liquid, but.
Barely stirred it, so you don't want it to go. There you go. The top's off, so you have to hold it right here.
So, it's always interesting to work in the kitchen with a little one.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Up and down and up and down.
Yeah.
I think she's going to make it, you guys.
Oh, well, hey, and what I always say, just wait till she comes and the coach's nephew grow up.
This morning.
Oh, it smells good, doesn't it?
It smells good. I would say my mushrooms are...
Show them.
Okay,
here comes her mushroom, onions,
but,
and garlic, and a little salt.
But I took
so just a little salt, and this is something that you can always do to add to the rice.
A leaves and the heating pad.
And you guys, guess what? Heating pad. This is my first time of cooking this recipe.
Oh,
And I think I'll do it again. I just love it.
But I took too many leaves. It seems to be. I'm okay. I'm
really
okay.
Really healthy for you. Yes. The spinach. I know Jackie's uncle gets like the best spinach.
Were you okay, Lauren?
Farm he gets it from. Really good. He's brought it in and shared it with us.
Thanks for the cheer up. Thanks for the cheer up.
When my spinach is
thanks for the cheer up.
I'm going to add a cup of rice. It's not cooked. The rice is not cooked. I'm going to add it after my spinach is ready, and then I'm going to add the chicken broth. And they call for dill. How many people? Dill. Yeah, they call for dill.
Like what?
I don't
how many like people? Dill, what? What do you mean by how many people?
Dill, but it might. I mean, it's a different flavor.
Yeah. But it's okay. Like my husband likes potato salad that's got dill in it. Tastes pretty good.
Yeah, maybe potato salad.
Oh, and you guys, remember how much spinach was there? Look how you can hardly see it now.
I can barely see the spinach. So all that spinach now that was it took up the whole pan has it's about a tenth.
Yeah,
1/10, I'd say, right?
Yeah, definitely. It's really reduced in size. And you know what? You could just serve it like this.
No,
I kind of got the spinach. I don't want to burn my spinach.
Yeah, no burning spinach.
No burning.
You can see, can I see? No, we're not going to hold it. You can see. It's okay. It's almost done, you guys. Almost done. It smells really good. I bet Coach's house smells really good, too.
Oh, yeah. Smells like Parmesan and shallots and garlic.
Woo! Smells good. Oh, my gosh. I think I've got a recipe that I'm going to keep. I can't wait to share it with my family. Okay, I want to show you guys.
You can show us.
Can you see how it's hardly?
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
That's really nice.
No, you have 15 more minutes. Yeah. It's like an L forever. It's an ever thing. Okay, so now I'm going to put my rice.
Does Barry like this stuff?
Yes, Barry will love this.
Where is he?
I'm putting my cup of rice in. It's not cooked.
Since we talked about Barry almost every day.
Since they got garbage and the pool too.
Uncooked rice. Okay, that's interesting.
I cleaned the pool.
And I never did it.
Kind of fall in there and then I have to go in and see.
I'm very excited and I coat the rice. I stir it and I coat the rice. And you know all that white rice that we had at Hidden Wings? I'm using that.
Oh, Debbie took the white rice.
Whoa, it's in the Hidden Wings box.
Hi, Erin.
Okay.
It's Erin's birthday tomorrow. It's your birthday.
Martha, can you unmute the
The good news is I'm no longer in pain.
Can you unmute it? I can't hear. There we go.
There we go.
Could we celebrate tomorrow your birthday?
Yes.
Want to celebrate?
And that's happy okay early with mom too? On Zoom?
Yeah, she said.
Yes. Okay, that's confirmation. So we
We got confirmation.
Yay!
All right.
I need a Richard.
We're gonna celebrate Erin's birthday tomorrow.
It's gonna be all about Richard Simmons tomorrow.
How old are you gonna be?
Yes.
How old are you?
Erin, how old are you gonna be?
I'm
13.
No.
And the morning said 7. And now it's 13.
13, you're moving up. You're getting warmer. You're getting warmer.
How old are you really, Erin?
How old are you really, Erin?
And almost 25.
25.
Whoa!
Oh,
wow, Erin.
Wow. You're older than I am.
Maybe Richard Simmons will make an appearance tomorrow.
What?
Maybe we can get Richard to come back for your birthday.
On Richard Simmons.
Oh, yeah.
How fun.
Ooh, yes.
Oh, yes. I'm going to be the DJ in the morning.
Oh, I'm good, not Tina.
We'll play a song for Erin.
No, that was actually.
No, Erin likes a few songs. She likes the chicken dance.
Yeah, the chicken
songs
dance.
I like Erin. Taylor Swift.
Erin, you have another favorite song now?
Erin.
Favorite song.
My favorite song?
Yeah.
What song do you want me to play tomorrow? Maybe the Mulan song?
The Mulan song?
Yeah, that's a great okay. one.
Mulan.
Mulan?
Mulan?
Mulan.
Yeah, Jen.
Okay.
Oh, good.
Yay.
One song, so I can get it ready for you. What song?
One song.
Maybe it's Reflections or...
Colors of the Wind.
You can't really come to my house.
Ooh. I'll surprise you.
Well, good idea, Tina.
What's her birthday? So
we know the chicken dance. We do the chicken.
We're gonna do the chicken dance.
We could totally do the chicken dance.
The chicken dance. That's already on the DJ list.
But what? The chicken dance?
Oh, well, tomorrow we can play chicken dance.
I'll surprise you, Erin.
You sure she likes it though?
Erin's
birthday too. Yes.
We'll get the chicken dance. What about the Macarena?
Does she like the Macarena?
Remember when Josh did it?
Yeah.
Remember when Josh? Yes. Remember when we had Josh do it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'm going to get the chicken and I'm going to get the Macarena.
We'll get the chicken dance.
Well, be prepared to be doing the chicken dance during the workout.
Got it.
You
gotta think at the old restaurant called the Old Vienna up in Gizmo.
If
I'm not mistaken.
We'll be warming up to the chicken dance.
In honor of Erin.
Maybe we have a plan.
Maybe there'll be a special writing for Erin tomorrow for poetry.
One day at a time.
A drawing?
We have a drawing lined up.
Drawing.
Guess what it is, you guys. What is Erin?
What is it?
So much.
Let me guess.
What does she like to eat?
What's your favorite?
What does she like to eat?
Chocolate.
Ice cream.
Tuna.
It's going to be a chocolate bar, you guys. We're going to draw a chocolate bar.
Yay. A chocolate for your birthday, Erin.
Teresa, we'll play videos for you tomorrow, okay? Two dance videos.
Yeah.
And then a special song from Mulan, maybe from Tina.
Yeah. Yep. And birthday candle meditation.
Yay!
Very cock. Oh, poor baby.
What happened?
Okay. Well, Debbie
it's
will
probably
have
nap picture. Time.
I just to let you guys know, I put 1¾ cup of chicken broth inside. Inside the rice. So that now the rice is cooking with all that other good stuff. Chicken broth, not stock. Right.
So she'll show us a picture.
Okay, guys. That was really
fun. Hope you guys enjoyed Cottage Kitchen today.
All right, guys.
See you all tomorrow.
Bye. Tomorrow.
Bye, guys. Bye.